Power BI artifacts are integrated with the Microsoft Office Information Rights Management and Data Protection capabilities. I can come into the settings for this Power BI report. I can set the data sensitivity level to, for example, highly confidential, as we can see here. And now if I come into the report and I try to export to Excel, for example, and I'll go ahead and open it up from here, you can see that the sensitivity level has been maintained in the Excel file that was generated. And if I happen to try to do the same thing from an unmanaged device, so for example, if I were accessing the same report from my home machine based on the policies, we can see that we have a policy that disallows export from an unmanaged device and the download is blocked. And as an administrator, I have a nice report showing the count of artifacts by different sensitivity level, the number of incidents, and it's fully integrated with Microsoft Cloud App Security. So I, as a security administrator, have a single pane of glass that shows full auditing across the whole Microsoft Office ecosystem, including the Power BI artifacts. So let's say I'm a business intelligence professional. I've put my love and dedication into building these datasets. These are rich semantic models that I want to have reused throughout my organization. How can I promote them? Well, we are introducing shared and certified datasets. So I can simply come into the settings for a dataset. We have this endorsement section. I can tag this dataset as promoted. Promoted means I'm putting my reputation behind this dataset. It is ready for general consumption. You'll notice there is another option here called certified. And to have it certified, I would need to go through the data governance process for my organization to have it certified as the single version of the truth. I'll go with promoted for now. And here you can see the dataset is tagged as promoted. So I'm now going to switch over to the consumption experience for the analyst. So I'm going to connect to Power BI datasets. I'm immediately presented with all of the datasets that I have access to in my organization. There could, of course, be hundreds or thousands of datasets listed here. We know that Power BI grows virally. So what we've done is we've improved the discoverability. We've put the certified and promoted datasets right there at the top of the list, making them really easy to find. So I'll go with the game revenue dataset that we just promoted. I'll click create, and I'm going to create a report in record time using the magic of copy-paste visuals in Power BI Desktop. And whilst it's loading, I'll go ahead and publish. So here's the key. I can publish this report to a different workspace than the one in which the dataset resides. Because of shared and certified datasets, I can absolutely do that. We can have business intelligence professionals that work in IT preparing these curated datasets in their own workspace and have analysts author reports that are stored in different workspaces. So I'll go ahead and publish this to the analyst workspace. So I happen to have it preloaded, so here it is. Here's my beautiful report. I'm very proud of this report. Maybe I want to pin some of these visuals to a dashboard. So here I've got this executive dashboard that's getting data from different reports and different data sets and different workspaces. Naturally, I want to make sure this data is coming from trusted sources. Well, we are introducing the new Lineage view, which allows me to see all of the interdependencies between the Power BI artifacts. So here is the dashboard, here are the reports it's getting data from. It's getting data from this promoted data set and this certified data set in a different workspace. If I want to see where that data set's getting its data from, I can just click on it. And I will now go to the Lineage view in the different workspace, and I can see exactly where this data is coming from. So here's the data set. And it's getting data from these data flows and these data sources. So as you can see, we are introducing an end-to-end 360-degree view from data source all the way through to dashboard across workspaces. Absolutely beautiful. And in the spirit of shared datasets, what if I want to consume data from a Power BI dataset using a non-Power BI tool? Well, actually, that's fine too. We recently introduced open platform connectivity using what we call the XMLA endpoint, where I can simply copy the workspace connection and I can now connect to it using a variety of analysis services client tools. In fact, most other major BI vendors support connectivity to Power BI datasets for data visualization, as well as management tools. For example, SQL Server Management Studio is the traditional management tool for analysis services. And so here I am connected to the same Power BI workspace. You can see here is the same workspace connection and the same data sets are listed. So here in SQL Server Management Studio, I can manage these data sets. I can perform deployments and scripting and debugging, etc. So I'm going to come into the data set properties for the game revenue data set. And we're going to zoom in here. And we can see that this Power BI data set is over 73 gigabytes in size. We are lifting the limit on Power BI premium dataset sizes to have parity with Azure Analysis Services, the scalability, the manageability, and the open platform connectivity. So here we have the Power BI homepage. As you can see, you can infuse your corporate branding, really make it your own. I'm going to click through to this app to show you the Power BI service, new look and feel. As you can see, you have this navigation section on the left that you as an app author can completely define. You can link to as much Power BI content as you want. So for example, here I'm linking to a paginated report in Power BI, and you can even link to non-Power BI content. So here I have a PowerPoint deck that is right here as part of my application. I can link to Word documents. Perhaps this is a training document to onboard new users. We can link to videos. Again, a training video. We can even link to a Microsoft Forms app to gauge customer sentiment. Literally, as an app author, I am only limited by my imagination. I can completely customize this app and take control. And in terms of the data elements, we've introduced extra metadata here for the title. So as you can see, I now have the ability to contact the report owner to ask questions. I have the last updated time. And in terms of the data visuals themselves, I, as an app consumer, not as a report author, just as an app consumer, I can completely customize the data that I'm looking at here. So I can, for example, change the data that I see on the axis to perhaps break it out by genre. I can change the visualization type to perhaps a stacked area chart, a donut chart, a tree map. I can change the measure, I can change the aggregation. Literally, I can completely customize this as the app consumer. And if I want to switch back to the default, I can do so in a couple of clicks.